Greetings, everyone. Yeah, all right. Move, making space. All right.
Just turn the TV off.
Yeah. Should probably do that. Go ahead and move my laptop. So I'm going to use this desk. Yeah. Showcase. Alright.
We're about to actually do it. Just let me know so I can put the mask on. Proper. I'll just keep it on right now.
Wait, do what?
When do you actually start to get to the unboxing?
You know it's not recording you guys, right? Mm. At least camera-wise.
Oh.
It's recording my camera, but it's recording your it's recording our audio, my mic, and also audio.
Alright.
I'll kill you!
Like what you see in the OBS screen.
Okay, okay.
Yeah. Ignore the Skype share.
Do you want me to just give you a countdown?
Yeah, I mean, like, I'm recording right now, but I'll just cut this shit out.
Yeah, but, like, when you're actually ready, I'll just give you a countdown.
Alright. ready.
Alright. The only take for the unboxing. Alright. 3, 2, 1, action!
Hey, everybody. DC here, and, oh boy, one, two, three,
Oh, by the way, we're here too.
Yeah, three giant bags from GameStop, and you can probably guess where I've been. I was at the midnight release for the Nintendo Switch, and I'm a goddamn sheep. Anyways.
Yeah. Oh, and just so you know who we are, hi, Rainbow Snake, here with Master Metallics. Or anyway, just hear us call him as Eric.
Yep. We are his Daybreak posse.
Yeah. They're joining me here because I don't know why.
Because he's boring alone.
Yeah. Yeah. This will go out at the same time as my channel overview, so they'll get that joke. Anyways, yes. So let's start with my real sins. I'm a goddamn sheep. So let's start with the accessories, shall we?
You're a weak soul.
Alright. So
yeah,
first.
Now I'm actually, weirdly enough, I'm a bit more interested in what the boxes look like.
Alright, first off, we got.
What we got here?
Carrying case.
Of course, essential for traveling.
Game Traveler Deluxe Travel Case. And, knife.
How many games does it hold?
Actually, why am I using this mini knife? Oh, there's my real knife. 1 second.
Yes.
Nope.
He's well prepared for this, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, let's do this. Oh, I can use a knife as a leverage.
Yeah, he got his Switch at the midnight release.
Is he using zip ties?
No. There we go.
Alright.
Meanwhile, I'm getting mine tomorrow. Which is still launch day.
I'm gonna be honest, guys. I'm waiting until, like, next year. I'll explain why. It's because, honestly, there's enough games at the moment that I'm satiated with. Hell, but you know what? Christmas, maybe.
Yeah, I mean, by that time, Odyssey will come out.
Yeah, most of the Yeah, because exactly. most of the other good games are coming out later.
Well, that's the thing. Everyone's fixated on the Switch's launch.
It's a pretty good launch.
But the thing is, what really matters is the launch window, which is the first cycle, the first annual cycle, basically from now until next March. And at that point, with that consideration, the Switch has one of the best launches we've seen since the PlayStation 2.
This, excluding third-party stuff that hasn't been talked about.
And of the third-party stuff that has been talked about, over 120 games.
Well, by which I mean more like ports that will come, you know.
Well, most of the shit isn't even ports. Ports is like, okay, 30, 40 games. That still leaves over 80 games.
Oh, boy.
Like, whatever the fuck Ubisoft is gonna come out this year, whatever other ones, I should say.
And here's the design for the carrying case. And it's not just drawn, it's actually etched. So you can actually feel it. And I think you could see it, too. Like, see the divots?
Yep, I see them.
Yeah, I can see them.
That's nice. That's
how many games can it hold?
Let me check.
Yeah, actually, is it zipper?
Yeah, it's a zipper, but there's a zip tie.
Oh, of fucking course. Who are they trying to keep out of the bag?
You should be using scissors for that one.
Or at least nail clippers.
Don't cut yourself.
There we go.
We don't want an accident to happen on this unboxing.
Ah! My A! Didn't that happen in Simpsons?
Which episode?
Regarding what now?
Okay, so we got foam padding.
Of course.
Got a nice little mesh bag with zipper for excess games.
Okay. They could just put in whatever the hell the volume is, and that's a mathematical nightmare.
Yeah. Then open up. So the Switch goes right here, and this covers the screen.
Yeah, pretty much standard.
But also comes with these.
Those are cartridge holders, right?
I put them up a little bit closer so I can, so I am, the viewers could see, like, exactly the volume of the carts.
They hold 4 games each.
Okay.
Games each, so right off the bat you can store 8.
Hey, by the way, are you gonna lick the cartridges?
Huh?
Are you gonna lick the carts?
Huh?
Oh, you didn't? Apparently they taste really fucking bad.
Also, included with the cartridge holders are memory card holders.
Oh, that's nice.
They're micro SD card holders, and they hold 2 each.
Oh.
So yeah, it comes with 2 of these, and each of these has 1 of these. So you can have 8 games here, or 7 games and 2 micro SD cards, or 6 games and 4. Micro SD cards.
Now tell me, from those little cartridge carriers, do they look like in comparison to, like, say, a DS card or a Vita card? Yeah, like, what do the cart
best,
like, the cart holders?
Actually, like, size wise, well, we'll see when we get to my Zelda.
When
you get to Zelda, you'll see, like, actual comparison. They're, slimmer,
slimmer, a little bit longer, you'd say?
Yeah, I'd say, actually, best comparison would probably be a Vita.
I said a Vita part.
Alright. And...
best comparison you can make.
Also, conveniently, there are slots for these.
Ah.
I think...
yeah.
I was wondering if there were slot holders for it.
Yeah, so this carrying case is actually pretty legit. Okay. It's here. Up next. I got all 5 of these things. The Zelda Breath of the Wild amiibos. Actually, hold on.
It's a little out of focus.
Yeah, Frick's in that. There we go.
Yeah. Alright. Okay, what are you showing here?
The book Coblin.
Coblin!
Eh, might as well, like, unbox these things.
Yeah. Gotta say, whoever did the enemy designs for Breath of the Wild, fine job.
See, the thing is, that's really confusing the hell out of everyone, including myself, especially, again, I'm the guy who, for a final paper for English class, I did a fucking paper on the goddamn Zelda timeline.
I would put fucking nerd right next to you.
Yeah, shit. Trying to open the amiibo. See, what I always like to do with amiibo is just keep these, because they have great art anyways.
Oh, yeah.
There we go. The thing that's confusing a lot of people is it's sharing an art style with Wind Waker and a bit Skyward Sword. Awesome.
Now, me personally, I've never cared much for the different timeline, but even if I did, it's art style. To me, that's all it is.
Well, no, the thing is, like, look at the games that follow...
With the exception of, like, Zoras.
The thing is, the timelines also follow art styles. Because the Toon Link... Because the adult timeline is all Toon Link. Because there you have, that's where you have, Wind Waker, Phantom Hourglass, and, Spirit Tracks. Those are all the, share the, Wind Waker art style. And in the adult timeline, which is a more realistic one, you have Majora's Mask and Twilight Princess. Especially Majora's Mask and Twilight Princess are different art style, but they share similar themes. And the Hero Fails timeline is 2D games. You have Zelda 1, Zelda 2, really Link Between Worlds, and Link to the Past.
Well, maybe I just really don't give a shit about the timelines then.
Well, no, I mean, it fits.
To be fair, though, so at some point you gotta cut loose on, okay, should, they're all...
And, so, here we have the Link, the horse rider one.
With the hood on?
Yep.
I see.
Yeah. You'll see it better when I take it out.
I wonder if there's an actual face behind the hood.
There is.
And how well it's done.
It looks pretty well done. See your face.
Yeah. I can see like a nose on it, so it's pretty good.
Yeah, and it has a mouth, but it has no eyes. Wow.
Then again, I don't think the paint could get there.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. What if they have the face, then the hood?
Maybe. I don't know.
We'd have to ask.
Actually, no, it looks like it was all together. It was all, part of...
Oh, the hood is, fully molded into the...
It looks like it's fully molded.
Okay. Alright, it makes sense. They just couldn't get there.
The Archer. Actually, one thing to note... Amiibo plastic. At least it's not like the garish yellow one for the Link Smash amiibo plastic.
Lest we not forget the purple one for Zelda Smash.
Oh yeah, that's right. Right here. At least yeah, it's purple. Hidden. At least it's hidden.
Well, at one point it was. Dress.
What are you doing looking under her dress, Snake?
He's got a point there.
I remember at one point it wasn't under the dress.
Ah, nice. Came off clean. Yeah, that's usually what I like to do with my amiibo things.
Huh. My amiibo thingamahoos and thingamajigs, gigawatts.
Jigahoo?
What point are you on gigawatts? Oh, what the? Oh.
What?
They tied the
string.
I almost fucking broke it. I didn't realize it.
God.
They wanted extra security for that one.
There we go. God damn. Also, reason I brought up the amiibo plastic. Looks pretty damn nice.
Now, that white little, mounting bit, I'd say that's, is that like, it looks a bit ceramic, or like the mold.
No, it feels plastic.
Okay.
In case you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm simultaneously reorganizing my amiibo collection.
Have to make the room.
Yeah, I do.
This guy's a sheep.
Yes, I am.
Goddamn amiibola.
Once you have it, it's an epidemic. Get rid of it.
It's an epidemic, I know, man.
It is.
I mean, even I find I still find myself falling for the symptoms.
Okay. Next one. My personal favorite. Zelda.
Woo. It's all my fault!
What's your fault?
I don't know. Whatever happens.
Everything.
My name is Princess Hilda. I will fail you in every way.
That's Hilda!
I know. I said
Hilda. You said Hilda.
No, you said Zelda.
I said Hilda.
Get your ears checked, boy.
It's on her business card, don't you know?
Looks pretty damn great.
I will fail you in every way.
Yeah, it looks amazing. All right. Last but not least.
Of the first bag.
The Guardian. This thing is fucking massive!
Yeah. I don't even know if there's gonna be enough room on your shelf.
Wait, what's the amiibo? Oh, it's that boss amiibo!
Yeah, the Guardian.
The, whatever you call that thing from Incredibles.
You're right.
God damn, you're right.
It's bigger. It's better.
It doesn't fit.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's too much for Mr. Incredible.
No, he's right. It's the goddamn, thing.
Yeah, it's the robot thingy. It's the robot thing.
Slice's place?
I think.
Wait, what'd you say?
Spicy Spice?
Something. It also helps at fixing your back.
That's right. I forgot about that scene.
If it pulls you just right.
You know the cool thing about this? That apparently, fully adjustable legs. We're about to put that to the test.
Bead.
God damn.
Well, there's one leg free.
That's a package they use for doubles, isn't it?
Yeah. It's adjustable, like it's like rubber.
I figured as much.
I think it might be like a what are those things? Like pipe cleaners?
I think I know what you mean.
Yeah, like you guys ever played with pipe cleaners?
Yeah.
No.
The hell do I get this thing out?
Do we have... Ooh, is there a bit of a problemo?
This thing is intricate. Do I just lift this thing up?
He doesn't know how to open it. DC, are you having malfunctions there?
I don't know.
There's a sex joke here somewhere. I'll find one.
Are you having wardrobe malfunction? Is your dick caught in the zipper?
No, not that. It's a little bit more finesse than that.
Okay. There we go.
Okay, then you tell it.
I know what the joke it isn't. I can't exactly say what joke it is though. I'm trying to think. Shit takes time.
Malfunctions or erectile dysfunction?
No.
No.
Yeah, getting you're right. Too easy. Only no, Eric would make that. God damn.
Getting it out of the pack. Getting it out of the pack. Nah, fuck it. It's too late.
Getting the package out.
No.
I put my package in your mailbox.
God damn, this thing looks awesome.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's too much for Mr. Incredible.
There we go. I should make some space.
Question. Would it be able to stand up on all of its low arms?
I think the legs might be too flimsy for that.
What I mean is, are all of its claws out flat?
A little.
Yeah, probably not anyways.
Alright. Well, that's bag one done. And at this point, I'm gonna... I might cut to, after I take these off and, put the trash in here.
Alright, what's next?
Oh, in that case, cut!
Wubba lubba dub dub.
Who's the opposite of wubba lubba dub dub? Am I right, folks?
That's the way the newsroom goes.
I don't give a fuck you think, Jerry. I'm gonna focus on why the cops don't blow your head off. They literally got a clear shot in your head. Can't believe this is what our tax dollars pay for.
What do you think of the preview to the new DuckTales theme?
You mean the show?
Yeah. Well, not just the show, but
Show off a part of the theme.
Mm-hmm.
Were you listening?
Yeah. I'm hearing a lot of
people talking to Eric.
Voice acting, and I'm just like, why?
Huh?
I'm hearing a lot of people don't like the voice acting.
With regards to, well, the thing is, because some of the actors are known for, like, comedies, like a good number of them are from SNL, like Bobby Moynihan, and Beck Bennett, and a number of them are from, like, shows like Community and stuff like that.
Yeah. Which one of you is the evil triplet? Louis? Eh.
I'm
hearing a lot of people complain about the art style.
It's not that bad for
I actually like it. I really like it.
It's a revamped modern aesthetic.
Some people are saying this should have been done in Flash. I disagree.
Huh?
I think it's fine.
Well, no, the thing is... The problem people are having, you know what it looks like?
What?
Powerpuff Girls reboot.
Yeah, nobody likes that much.
Like, that clean art style, the modernized as opposed to retro, like, original classic art style. It's reminding people of Powerpuff Girls. Well, actually, no. Powerpuff Girls and Teen Titans Go.
Teen Titans Go, I would not say...
It doesn't look good, but it looks similar. It's Flash. It looks like Flash animation.
My problem with the new Powerpuff Girls isn't the art style itself. It's what they did to the villains. It's their art style. If that makes any sense.
A little.
Alright, trying to read up some attempted Frieza character names in this hub. Refridge.
Refridge. Jesus Christ. Okay.
Hold on. Are we back?
Yeah, I might not have cut here because we went into a tangent. So, what's next?
Well, that and you were doing something.
What's next? Switch or Zelda?
Zelda. The Switch is the main event.
Yeah, Switch is the finale.
Hang on, before you do that, Beck!
I might not have actually cut, so... Got posters. And I'm looking around my room to see if I have room to put them in. No.
If you don't have room for one of them, can I have one?
I got two for a reason, because they're double-sided.
Janemba's Pikachu.
I'll give you $15.
Wait, what do you get?
I'll give you $15 for one of them if you can't find room for both.
Yeah, we'll see you come MomoCon.
Yeah.
Alright. This thing is 3 times the size of the Switch box. Also, box is edged too.
Nice.
Even though most people are going to throw it away.
Oh, I keep this shit. I still have my Mario Maker Wii U bundle box. And I still have my Uncharted 4 PS4 box.
My mom is sort of a hoarder, so I don't keep boxes of stuff lying around.
Well, I have that shit in my closet.
Mm.
All right.
Let's see. Ooh, I got a beer's glare.
Yeah, trying to hide my receipts. Don't want anyone peeking off of my codes.
Hey, here's DC's codes. I'll start the bidding at $10.
Holy shit! This thing has a carrying case.
Oh shit.
Fuck. Well.
Put him up. I love this Evo.
Okay, well, let's see what it comes with, because otherwise I might have goofed up and I might actually return the,
Do you see?
Holy shit! Hold on. I'm comparing.
How much was the carry? How much was the other one?
$30.
I will pay you $35 for the blue one if you don't want to use it.
This one?
Yeah.
Maybe.
The what now?
Because, like, the thing is, I thought this was going to be, like, a felt type of thing. Actually, hold on. Let me take a look.
Wait, he got an extra carrying case?
It came with the Master's Edition. I thought it was going to be, like, a felt cover. Hold on.
Oh, jeez.
Did something mislead you into thinking it was felt?
Yeah. Legend of Zelda Master's Edition.
Give me one moment.
So what else you got there? What else you got there, my boy?
Holy shit, they changed it.
What'd they change?
They must have changed this to hardcover. Because I just went into the pictures. It looks a lot different than that felt one originally. Maybe it was the special edition. Maybe this is Master's Edition and the Feld one is for special edition. Oh my god, and it's got games. And it's got game cases. Oh my god. Holy shit. So, funny story. I was going to get a case similar to this one where it has, like, little slots.
Mm-hmm.
But... And like
that was for you.
Like a, well, no, like if you go to GameStop, it's like a starter kit, type of deal. Mm. But the only one they had was like a Mario one. So I wasn't really gonna bother with that one, but because they didn't have the Zelda one. But holy shit, this looks okay. Side by side comparison. This one. This one's basically generally empty because of space. You have a felt mesh that's protecting the screen. And you have the two cases here. The two game cases. And it's got little holes here for the triggers. The Joy-Cons.
Triggers!
Meanwhile, this one. Oops.
So much zippy.
It's flat, so not much room for the zippers. But it's got pocket here for like earbuds and shit like that.
And a charger.
Yeah, and it's got a lot more slots for games. Like, I honestly don't know which one I prefer.
Hmm. Whatever one.
But I love the outside design. It's, oh my god, this looks amazing. It looks like the actual, like, a Sheikah slate from the game.
Yeah.
Well, I guess, I'll see with time which one I prefer.
Which one? In time! So what else?
Alright, what
there?
Else is in there? That is the game.
Another box.
Another fucking box.
Zarya mystery gift. Zarya mystery gift. It's a box. And another box. And another box. And another box. Eh, fuck this.
Wait, when did this become Zarya's Christmas emote?
Yeah, when did this become a fucking monthly Yoshika?
If it's not boxes, Zarya either pulls out a robot that she breaks, or a teddy bear that she hugs but breaks the head off.
That one makes me a little sad.
But she's just too strong, man.
Too strong.
Too strong or too strong?
Strong.
Yeah. Yeah, the latter. Strong.
Be careful, dude. You don't want to stab the thing.
Yeah. Oh no, we murdered the game! Actually, is the game in there?
I think that's a figure.
Oh, right. Isn't there This thing came with a figure, didn't it? Oops, there's a scratch on it.
Ooh, no.
No. That would be worth nothing. Let's see it. Oh, yeah, it's the sword.
The master sword. Fire laser beams.
Now, cool as that is, I would have kind of liked to see a Link figure. But I think I know why they didn't do it, and it's because people would have, they would have probably had to, like, outsource to a figure company. I don't think they want to do that.
Thank you. So, pedestal looks great. The detail on the flowers is amazing.
Does it look like the pedestal has a bunch of moss on it? I can't tell.
Rubber. However, the detail on the rubber is amazing. Look at the rust on the sword. This is quality. For me, I don't care if the figure is rubber as long as it's still detailed. Yeah, it looks like the pedestal has moss painted on it.
Okay.
And holy shit, not only is this sword rusted, but it's also sort of greenish.
Hmm. Damn. Like steel has been tarnished?
Yeah. Well, shit. Master Sword really went to shit.
It seems like this is a massive time jump.
Well, they did say
that we have technology.
Calamity Ganon struck.
Wait, Zelda. We're not cavemen. We have
technology. Find out. Complete your destiny. Find out what happened 100 years ago. And hell, maybe if we find out what happened 100 years ago, maybe we'll find out where in the timeline this game fits in.
Yeah.
Alright. So I'm putting this here for now.
Next,
we have a few things.
Such as?
Well.
The game itself.
But I'll save that
for a second. Let's look at that box a bit.
Yeah, let's see the box.
Later. First.
Weird enough, I'm not that interested in the box art.
Yeah, we just want to see the size. Wait a minute.
It's a coin. A Sheikah coin.
Uh-huh.
The Eye of the Sheikah. With the logo.
That is going to be a bitch whenever it starts to wither. That makes any sense. You ever had like a really good looking coin, but over the years it just starts to look smudged and shit?
Not really. I'm trying to actually open this. God damn it.
I used to own coins as a coin collector.
DC will now become Two-Faced and use that coin to decide the fate of people.
But you'd have to put an X on one of the sides, and I know for a fact he would never do that.
Yeah, you're right.
See?
Or you could just treat it like the Z with the sword means you get stabbed.
I have a three-sided
also,
die.
Also, holy shit!
I have a three-sided die. This one, you live. This one, you die. This one, we go out for hot cocoa.
Huh?
Robot Chicken reference.
Yeah.
All right, call it heads or tails.
How about we just put tails?
I call Sheikah.
Sheikah. And Snake.
I call Z.
And Snake calls the logo. Sheikah gets it.
Yeah. Hey.
I win. What do I win?
Nothing.
Yeah!
Welcome to Escalator Land! When do we get our rides? This is the ride!
Yippee! Next time we're going camping.
What is that a reference to?
Really? Appearance.
Let me guess, that's a map?
Oh my god, it feels nice.
Is that a map? Yep, that's a freaking map. Is that a map of the entire land?
Well, first...
What's on the backside?
That is the entire land, isn't it?
I see... what looks to be a salamander? A bird? Camel? An elephant?
And a dragon.
Hmm, yeah. Okay.
Hmm. Whatever.
And
And I say salamander because it's on fire. It looks like a lizard.
It's
reptilian, amphibian, and whatever the hell.
Also,
the salamander
you
is.
Want to see some know some great detail? Look closer. It's faded. Look at some of the spots.
Oh.
It's like clouds, or it's a worn map. Hyrule world map. Central Hyrule. You have Elden.
Now, could you actually describe for the viewers and us, what does that feel like?
It feels like a tapestry. Like, it feels like canvas.
Ah!
Feels really nice.
Kind of has, like, an old feeling to it?
Yeah, it feels like a scroll. Like, it feels like parchment.
Okay.
Give me the dragon scroll!
The what now?
The dragon scroll.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You know what I'm talking about, Dragon Warrior?
It's called the Dragon Scroll? That was called something else.
Maybe it was something else, but I just remember it because it was the scroll for Dragon Warrior.
Kung Fu Panda was a great movie. So were 2 and 3.
Good news.
I haven't seen 2 or 3, but I'm shocked that the sequels were actually good.
Dude, they were pretty damn great.
Yeah. I'm shocked. If that's true, I'm actually shocked.
I've seen most of 2. Haven't sat there in a while.
And?
I like what I've seen.
Well, usually it's because,
we got soundtrack selection. Woo! I know what I'm listening to.
When the video's over.
More like when I sleep, or when I'm not playing the game.
Well, first you're gonna convert it to MP3.
I tried that with the soundtrack disc that I had for Twilight Princess HD. Copyright protection.
Oh. Do you have a CD player then?
Yeah. I mean, I have my computer.
That works.
And now, the game.
So before you actually, take the plastic off, but before you actually open it, I actually want to see what the case itself looks like. Those are its dimensions.
Very small. Also.
I'm reminded. DC.
Also, you want to know something weird that I know? I mean, no, look at the back. Look at the back.
It reminds me of PSP game cases.
Yeah.
I was about to say.
Yeah, that's immediately what I thought.
So.
Someone
the
cartridges
that are similar to that of a Vita, and the game cases are like that of PSP.
Wait a minute.
It's almost like Nintendo's actually learning from their competition.
Yeah. Hoodoo! Well,
nope.
I was assuming they're still in competition, because they claimed that they weren't, because I remember at one point they said, oh, we're not going to try to compete. We're just going to do our own thing.
Oh, Nintendo?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I mean, it makes sense, considering that, most of the shit that, the thing is, Sony's working, not focusing on the console market anymore, neither is Microsoft. Sony and Microsoft are in competition with each other, while in the road to compete with PC.
Yeah. If I'm gonna be honest, it's all just kind of a wank fest.
Well, no shit.
Alright, now let's see that cartridge.
Yeah, just pop open the box.
And then
does it open it easily?
Yeah.
And lick it.
Yep.
Holy shit, this thing's tiny.
Oh Jesus, that's a lot of unused space. Alright.
This thing's tiny.
Lick it.
No, thank you. And yeah. It went right here.
This is what the case that's
a lot of unused space.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, but then again, it's not wasted because of the art.
That's
yeah,
true.
The art paper's there.
I think you can put a little bit more in there.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Holy shit, this thing is fucking tiny.
Could have at least thrown in, like, some sort of small,
Yeah, that basically looks like a Vita cart without the curve.
Yeah.
It's about the size of my thumb.
Vita card.
Half your thumb.
No, like, the well, yeah. My thumb part of my thumb.
My thumb part of my thumb. Yes.
The, the furthest digit from the palm.
The part that has my nail.
Yeah. Like I said, the furthest digit from the palm.
All right.
Nerd!
Time!
It's almost like I have family members who are fucking doctors.
But yeah, I fucking love this box.
Oh. You see, I'm gearing up for the Switch here.
Not yet. Got one more thing before that.
You love that box.
Come on.
Also,
Dungeon Master and
first off,
Battle Box OTP.
Got a small little bag here full of goodies. Now I'll tell that story while I open this son of a bitch.
Oh, the Pro Controller.
Yep.
HD vibration.
See, the thing is, the thing is, I got it. Like, I don't mind using the Joy-Cons. I have a feeling, like, my hands are big, but not that big.
But.
So. No but. Yeah. No but. Actually, I picked up this thing mostly because I heard it was going to work with the PC.
Oh. That's weird. I mean, that's nice, but weird that Nintendo would do that.
Hey, if I'm paying $80 for the son of a bitch.
Most expensive controller so far.
No,
I mean,
no.
Well, like, here's hold on. Actually, I think this was 70. Either 70 or 60. The Joy-Cons,
for $70,
a pair of Joy-Cons is 80. But the thing is, with how much shit that's crammed up into them, that's a steal, because they're, I think, $50 individually.
Yeah, I was...
Actually, why the hell did I close this thing? Also, this thing's been going on for about an hour.
Whoopee. We'd be at the Switch already.
Well, hang on.
If I wasn't a sheep, yeah. Basic USB charging cable.
What kind of port?
No, it's not USB.
Are you sure about that?
What do they call this thing?
Let me see. I'm trying to see the connection.
Includes a rechargeable lithium-ion battery that can last about 40 hours on a single charge before first use. Charge Pro Controller with Nintendo Switch AC adapter or the included USB charging cable.
Yeah, it's a USB. I can see it from here.
No. Look at the port.
Oh, that's USB-C. I know about that. That's USB-C.
That's right. That's right. They did talk about USB-C.
No, I'm talking about the other end, though.
Well, yeah, it is USB, but it's not like micro USB. It's not standard USB. So, huh. Okay.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
That's actually very interesting.
All right.
Talk about moving ahead. I think they're the first company to actually push USB-C heavily.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then the controller.
It looks a little bit small for me.
And feels standard.
Compare it to the PS4 controller.
Could you describe the tension on the sticks?
Have you tried the Wii U joysticks? Or the Wii U Pro Controller?
No.
Feels similar.
Okay. How does that compare to
the buttons,
say,
the
DualShock
button.
4?
Yeah, break out your DualShock 4 and compare the size and shape. Wink, wink. Yeah, a little less wide.
Yeah. Tension feels more or less the same. Maybe a little bit loose.
This is something I've been noticing with my DualShock 3 controllers, but do the sticks creak in any way?
What do you mean, creak?
My DualShock 3 sticks creak a little bit when I move them.
Not really.
Okay.
And digital triggers.
Digital triggers.
Means instead of actually pressing them, it's buttons.
Not sure how I feel about that.
Hear that?
Yeah.
So it's just standard one button push. Granted, the Pro Controller for the Wii U did the same thing. Actually, all the GameCubes, actually every controller except for the GameCube used digital only. The GameCube had digital and analog. Because you pressed it down, and there were some games that responded to the analog, but you also clicked it down. But Nintendo controllers outside of the GameCube have never used analog.
Okay.
I mean, yeah, it feels pretty comfortable. Okay. Also, there's a bit of a screen here. Yeah, this is where the camera would be. Yeah, I mean, the thing is, the price for this thing makes sense when you consider the fact that this has everything that the Joy-Cons have. Because you have the IR camera from the left from the right Joy-Con, and you have the NFC reader, and you have the gyro and accelerometer. So, I mean, honestly, it makes perfect sense that it'd be as expensive as it is.
For those Splatoon players that like their motion control.
You mean like you?
It makes sense that it would be like that. The problem is, it's as expensive as the other ones, and people just, they want a cheaper alternative.
Not gonna happen.
Yeah, that's the thing.
How much tech is in those sons of bitches? Not gonna happen.
Just in a lot of controllers, really.
Huh?
Just in a lot of controllers, really.
Alright, so, before we move on to the main event, notice this small bag here. So, when I was at GameStop, they basically started throwing away the shit that they had for pre-order bonuses that they never gave away. So, let's try and build the suspense. Let's feather up to the tip and strangle it while we get to this.
Hold on. Wait.
Or, Snake, how did you put it?
Do what?
How'd you put it, like, the teasing?
Feather on the cock?
Yeah.
Feather right on the cock?
So we have a mask. This was the Dishonored 2 pre-order bonus. It's double-sided because you have one side for Corvo, one side for Emily.
Okay.
And fabric actually feels really good.
Wait a minute.
Do you feel like looking like a fool and trying it on?
Both ways? Yes, absolutely.
Thank you.
Let's see it. You don't.
Ah, my hair's in my eyes.
You look stupid.
No shit. And this is very simple, but and also
you try to rob a place in
you,
that.
You can also wear like a balaclava.
Seriously, why do I picture you trying to rob a place
where it's like thing? Full except the eyes?
Yeah, that's right.
I can see you trying to rob a place wearing a full mask.
Other side.
Alright, bitch, you stick him up! This is a bank robbery! I'm serious!
This one works a bit better.
You know why it looks weird?
Why?
The glasses.
Yeah, your glasses make it look weird.
Yeah. Hold on.
It looks stupid.
A little bit better.
Yeah. And it feels really comfortable.
Mm. All right, next.
Ignore the hat hair. Up next, we have Lego Dimensions. Limited edition Green Arrow.
Okay.
Oh shit, you actually do put it together.
Yeah, you gotta put it together. And now we gotta watch.
It's even got a little chip. This and was now, meant for Lego Dimensions.
Now, for a brief moment, this unboxing video will turn into a Lego building video.
Chip, put it backwards.
You suck at these building videos.
We know what they usually do in Lego building videos. Unless they want to go full step by step, you know what they usually do?
What?
Fast forward!
Yeah, I know, right? Take your time, DC. Take your time.
It's got a little touch to put, like, the hood on. Hmm. Oh my god, this thing's double-sided! The head is double-sided! I repeat, the head is double-sided.
So it's like a bad cop from... So it's like bad cop and good cop from the Lego movie?
Ugh, lord.
Fast forward!
Take your time, DC. Take your sweet ass fucking time.
Shut up, Kenny. Sorry, that voice sounded like something from South Park. I like girls with really big titties. I like girls with really big titties.
Of course, you're looking at the damn paper.
Just trying to see if I have the bow the right way. There we go. But yeah.
And there we go. DC took a long time just to build the one Lego figure.
Well, no, I didn't realize. Like, look, it has a little thing for the hood. Pretty nice touch. Yeah, look. It's on that way. Yeah, like.
Yeah,
it's like this. Waiting for camera to autofocus.
Move the mouse.
Yeah, anyways. And?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like,
Oh my god, he's bald! And he's Two-Face!
Yeah! That's actually pretty cool. Let's see why it's limited edition.
He's the real Two-Face all along.
I'm putting this... where do I put you?
Okay, now then, next!
I'm putting you with the other Green Archers. There we go.
Green Archers? What?
I'm putting him with my next to my Ocarina of Time Link amiibo. Okay.
Alrighty.
Next!
Archers in fiction feel the need to wear green.
For Planet Robobot stickers!
Yay!
A dead rising force snow globe.
That's pretty cool.
Frank West holiday Rose, snow globe.
Rosebud.
God damn, we're not doing a commentary of Citizen Kane. The only things that we're gonna say is like, this is the best movie ever, or man, this shit is overrated.
Snake.
Yeah.
Watch your doors.
There's two opinions to that
movie. Even if you said it as a joke.
I'm saying that's what people say.
Hey, look.
Whether I agree with it or not is
up. He's got a fucking baseball bat.
Shake it.
Yay.
DC, shake the snow globe.
Nice. That's actually pretty cool.
Okay.
Up next, Watch Dogs 2 pins.
Oh, pins? Yo, fucking pins?
And speaking of pins, For Honor pins, Team Samurai.
Okay, hang on. I'm picking Samurai when I get For Honor, so can I get that? Are you picking Samurai 2?
Yes. And, last but not least, Dragon Ball Z Super Saiyan Goku Ki Chain. Eric,
oh, I got my copy.
Ah, you already got one?
Yeah, I got one of
those. Damn it, I got two, because I was going to give you one.
Oh, wait, hang on. Can I get one then? Just so all three of us can have one.
Maybe. But, yeah, that's... That was what was in the... That's basically all the free shit that they were trying to give away for the, all the leftover, like, all the pre-order leftovers.
Was it just, like, first come, first serve for that stuff?
Basically, they just threw a bag, full of this shit and said, here, free shit!
You just took it?
We went at it like fucking locusts.
Move, bitch!
I'm gonna... Yeah, I'll put this... Actually, where do I want to put it? Alright.
Now, it is time...
It's time to do.
We will be playing not just any children's card game.
It's time for your main event.
But a shadow children's card game.
All right. How do we want to do this?
Oh, hang on a second. Cue me for a drum roll.
Hold on. Actually, where the fuck's my phone? Oh, here it is.
What, you go?
Holy shit! Nintendo stocks went up by almost 4% today. Talk about a good launch.
Yeah, 5 seconds or else I just do a drum roll.
I'm tempted to go to my Walmart just to
one,
see, but I doubt it.
2, 3, 4, 5. Fuck it!
Go, go, go! Come on, DC, bring the box!
Hold on. You know what? Do I want something suspenseful or uplifting?
Uplifting.
Oh, admiring this box first.
And stop.
Oh! Oh, what? Oh, so some Walmarts are doing good headphones.
Alright, and stop music.
I'm tempted to go to my Walmart check. I am tempted.
Alright.
Some Walmart are doing a midnight release.
14 music?
Yep. You'll get to it. Heaven's Ward.
Nice. I'm tempted. It's like three. It's 2 minutes to midnight. I'm tempted
All right.
To check if my Walmart is doing it.
First off, console. But I'm showing that last.
Hi, Joy-Cons.
Next, we have. Yeah, I got the blue and red.
Oh, I gotta know!
USB cable. Add that.
Apparently, there's a button on the Joy-Cons that, for whenever you click it in.
Yes. They showed
I'm
that's a.
That's a safety precaution for the inevitable.
No, that's like, how they lock in.
Otherwise, like, inevitable, you know, just. It pulls out.
That's how they lock in place.
You know what? I'm gonna be right back.
No, you're not, Eric.
Yes, I am.
You're seriously gonna ditch us?
Well, I some Walmarts are doing midnight release. I gotta check if mine is.
How close is your Walmart?
It's like 10 minutes away.
Just fucking go. I can hold this.
Snake. Don't make sure he doesn't do anything stupid.
I'm not you, okay?
No, you're right. You're worse.
Yeah, Eric, he's not you or me.
Yeah.
DC, he's worse. Anyway, I'll be back.
Alright. I'll try to stall.
You can't upload all of this to YouTube.
Alright, put the USB cable and put the USB cable away.
Pro tip, stock up on USB-Cs. Did you hear what I said?
Yeah. Alright, so, we have, straps for the Joy-Cons, we have this little gem, the Joy-Con grip. Oh, good! We don't have a brick like the Wii U.
Oh, really?
Have you seen the Wii U power cable?
I've seen it.
It's like a laptop, it's a brick.
Yeah, that is the brick to end all bricks.
Yeah, it's like basic plug, but then it has a giant brick in the middle. But yeah, simple,
so
I could carry-
it just has a plug brick.
Well, yeah, but I mean, I could carry this with me.
Yeah, that's easy. That's fucking easy.
You know I'm going to be carrying this with me at MomoCon, right?
Oh, yeah. We're going to be carrying you. We're going to be carrying you around like Bernie.
Weekend at DC's?
Weekend in Atlanta.
All right. And now, we have the dock. Durable plastic. Okay.
Where are the sides?
It has a little hole
a nice little back cover to hide the cables.
Nice. That's nice.
Holy shit, this is a lot thinner than I thought it'd be. Huh.
Damn.
Huh. If you really need it, I'll just loan you one of my... I have some carrying bags. I'll just loan you one of those.
I have a laptop bag.
Mm.
And hell, I mean, again, I have those carrying cases.
Yeah. But those won't carry everything.
And the pièce de résistance. The pièce...
Pièce de résistance.
There we go. So, are you going to treat it like a mobile phone and just let it charge for a while?
First? Yeah, for a bit. I mean, we do have to record the other videos.
Oh, yeah. Alright. So, how would you describe the size of your hands? I said, how would you describe the size of your hands? Would you say they are particularly big? Would you say they are yaoi hands?
The triggers are really digital. Oh, they're click. So you have to put a little bit more pressure on the.
Do you feel it cramping? Your fingers feeling a little bit cramped?
Hold on, let me try. Where did I put them? Here.
Damn.
These things. Because actually, they're big enough to... Hold on. Can't get these off.
Huh? Are you kidding me?
Hold on. Oh, there we go.
Did you have to press the release button particularly hard? What was the problem?
No, hold on. Son of a bitch. Well, the thing is, I don't want to, press too hard. Actually, hold on. Well, the buttons are pretty sturdy.
Mm.
God damn.
I'm going to chalk this up to factory defect.
No, it doesn't feel... Like, it just feels like it might be stuck. Hold on. There we go. The hell?
Is something wrong?
No, I'm just wondering. There's like a lock thing here, but I don't know what exactly it's locking.
Maybe it's locking itself in place.
Hmm.
Yeah, that might be it.
See, I took engineering classes. I know this stuff.
Oh, let me try it again. There we go. Just had to force it a little bit. But yeah, I mean, all right, let's try it. Yeah, I mean,
this is the real litmus test for, like, big hands. Did you ever have a problem with a Game Boy Advance SP? Like, did you ever feel like your fingers were a bit cramped? Those.
A little.
Now, see, I had a big problem with those.
Okay, so,
or at least I have a problem using those now.
I mean, I can definitely see myself getting used to this. They feel a bit wide, actually.
Really?
Well, because of the strap thing.
Hmm.
Definitely gonna take some getting used to, but I don't feel like I can do it. Gonna be weird with the D-pad, though. But, yeah. I mean, like, I can see myself maybe, like, shifting, like, keeping it like this. Mm-hmm. Like, not exactly on my palm.
Try holding the red one sideways, just so you can,
like this, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's definitely going to take some getting used to.
Now hold the red one horizontally in two hands.
Well, it'd be kind of the same thing. It's just a matter of which hand.
Yeah.
Because, like, if you're holding it like this.
Now, how does it feel trying to press the shoulder buttons doing that? Like, accurately. With little shifting.
Relatively alright. I mean, these things help. Like, really help. My only main concern with this, my palm keeps pressing against the goddamn bumper.
Yeah, that's a problem that I've kind of kept in mind.
Actually, the red one feels a lot more natural.
Really? That's odd.
I mean, the only thing, if anything, like, getting myself to having to position this hand to have some leverage to press on the shoulder is a bit weird, but
yeah, you gotta kind of claw that shit.
Yeah, like that. Just support it at the bottom.
Hmm.
But yeah, like, holding it like that feels pretty natural.
So anyways, now we've got that. Let's do the final. Let's do the final touch. Take off the safety straps. Let's slide those suckers onto. Well, actually, we gotta slide them onto the controller bed first.
Yeah. There we go. Oh, I see what it is. The lock thing. It has a little lock, secondary locking thing. They really don't want you to throw these at your TV.
Yeah.
I see what it was.
Because admittedly, the little strap on the Wii remote wasn't the best.
The second strap was.
Hmm.
God damn. There we go. I have to take some getting used to with these straps specifically because of how little space you have for leverage. Okay. Actually, quick test.
Old litmus test.
The analogs feel a bit weird.
Really?
Well, they feel like you have a smaller range of movement.
You probably do. What's the tension like on it?
Not too stiff.
Hmm. Different than the Pro Controller?
Yes.
Okay. You ever tried a Vita? Is it comparable to that?
I haven't tried a Vita.
I'll bring mine.
Okay. I mean, it feels smaller, definitely, but...
it's gonna be weird trying to play Street Fighter with that.
Well, you know why it'd be weird for me.
Yeah.
Six buttons.
Well, even ignoring that, let's assume you don't have much of a problem with six buttons. You're not using a D-pad.
I would never use a D-pad for Street Fighter.
Exactly. Speaking of, how does a D-pad on the Joy-Cons feel?
You mean the D-buttons?
Oh, it's buttons! Ooh.
Because remember, for sideways.
Right, right. Oh god, that would feel even weirder for Street Fighter.
Hmm. I don't know, it's... Honestly, without the straps, it actually feels comfortable. The smaller bit, actually. I don't know. This is definitely something that's going to take some getting used to. But let's try this out.
Now show the face of it to the camera. Because you gotta show off the little dog. Rough.
Honestly, I can get all very used to this. Holy shit. This feels great, actually.
Hmm.
Compared to this? I don't know. I'm actually torn between... I mean... For one thing, the buttons feel different. Like, you can hear it's a hard press, right?
Mm-hmm. Actually, how does the D-pad on that feel?
A bit.
Do some quarter circles.
Yeah, pretty good.
Okay. And I say that because fighting games are the litmus test for D-pads.
Actually, the only thing, if anything, for me is... pressing them down feels a bit weird. Yeah, I mean, this is definitely something that's going to take some getting used to.
Hmm.
mean, hey, it is first of its kind.
Yeah.
Okay, it's a lot easier to take them out. I think it's just because of that locking mechanism in the strap.
Yeah. Now, before you actually put those on, I hear there's a very satisfying sound when you click them on.
It's the switch.
Mm.
Sound.
It's, you know, nice sound.
The snap and the that little snap. All right.
Yeah.
Quick little test run. Huh. Very. It's a little. Hold on. It's a little heavier than the gamepad.
Well, it's a lot less. I think there's a bit more computer stuff in there and less weightless plastic, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
What kind of tablet would you say the size is comparable to?
Like one of those Android Edge things? Here's the size.
I kind of... you know what it makes me feel? Think of...
Hold on.
Amazon Kindle Fire? Again, that's all my parents have.
Yeah, it makes sense. Ah, I did it.
What?
Okay.
You did what?
The kickstand. It is designed to pop off.
Oh!
Look. Because it's very flimsy. Push it out. Pops right off. But you just...
it just clicks right back in?
Yeah. So have no fear. You no longer have to worry about being live in fear of being a fucking dipshit who leaves their kickstand on when you put it back in the dock. You've seen that video, right? Of the guy with the switch, he has his kickstand up, docks it, and it flips right out.
Is that the guy who's trying to say that the kickstand is shit?
Maybe. Actually, before I pop this baby in, should also note, kickstand hides the SD card.
Hmm.
Now to put this 64 gig thing in.
Yeah. You're gonna have to format that.
Already did.
Nice.
There we go. It feels a little bit weighty, but it looks good. Really good, actually. Volume and game card slot. Only thing is, you can't really charge it while it's in tabletop mode with a kickstand. Because the charger is on the bottom.
Yeah.
All right. Well, then. I'm going to go ahead. Oh, well, first, that was my Switch unboxing video. Fucking an hour and 35 minutes. Because it's not just my Switch unboxing video, it's my Switch Midnight Release unboxing video. Fucking hell. Actually...
Three parts are cuts.
Actually, hold on.
I mean, if you do get a Switch, I actually think of giving you this.
Like, at the earliest, Christmas time.
Hmm. Well, like you said, you're most likely going to wait till Odyssey comes out.
Yep.
Because, oh my god, this looks so good.
And whatever the hell that, because I think I was the first to notice this out of all of us, but, it looks like they have a new version of KOF 98 on there.
Actually, moves around quite a bit, actually.
But... well, it needs to move around just the right amount. Kind of has to work like...
it's a little...
like, a brain and a skull.
I mean, this is...
just the right amount, not too much.
I mean, it's a bit big for it. I don't know. Definitely.
What it needs to do is, like, shelter the Switch like a brain inside a skull.
Yeah.
Here's a real litmus test you need to do. Hover it over your bed, hold it vertically, shake it a little bit, see if it falls out. That makes sense?
Well, it has a Velcro strap.
Like, no. Like, if it slides out of the Velcro strap, that's when you know, this might be a problem.
No, it's actually pretty tight. It's tight and secure, and it's not gonna, like, I don't really think it's gonna slide out. And besides, it's got a zipper, and damn, this thing is sturdy. I don't know. I like how forming this one is, because it just fits naturally onto it.
Like a glove?
Because it has, like, slots for the triggers. And this fits snug. Like, this is snugly fitting.
Hmm.
Huh. This is gonna take some experimentation. Some, like, few days of trying it out.
Yeah.
Huh. Well, either way, I got two really good cases, and they both look fantastic, so... yeah. I honestly don't know. Well, yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed this. And this is definitely going to be an adventure.
Oh, yeah.
This is Nintendo's trial run.
To be honest, this seems like a make or break.
It is. With how spectacularly the Wii U failed... this is Nintendo's last chance to stay as a first-party developer. If this puppy fails, fortunately, that means the end of Nintendo as a first-party company and as a console holder.
Yeah. If this fails, they'll go the way of Sega.
Exactly. Essentially, yeah.
Although, instead of Sega kind of... just the difference in time shows a difference in, like, how they died.
Yeah. Well, hope you guys enjoyed this video.
Yeah.
Actually, hold on. I want to see how... snugly this USB fits. Huh! USB-C! Essentially, the USB way of telling Apple to go fuck itself.
Oh.
Because USB-C, doesn't matter which way you put it in.
Oh!
Remember, that was the only good thing about, that Apple brought to the table?
Yeah.
Alright, well, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I know I sure did.
Keep it in your pants.
Today's just been a great day.
Mm-hmm.
And
but anyways, I have been Rainbow Snake.
I'm DC, and the guy who just left was Eric. And thanks for staying tuned to this midnight release version of Gear Up for Dungeon Crawl.
Yep. Y'all have a good night.